Okay, hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and thought I'd do a little recording. Actually, testing out my new camera, so you guys will have to tell me what you think. So far, I like it, but I'm trying to get all the settings right. It's got a lot of auto settings, and kind of hard to figure out which ones to turn off and which ones are going to work. I don't think I'm going to tell you what the camera is. Maybe I'll tell you guys next time, but I don't want to jade anybody's opinion, so I want to know what everybody thinks before I throw out what it actually is. But it's got one of its features. It's got this thing called follow focus, so it will actually adjust the focus while you're drawing, while you're moving, which is kind of nice, I guess. But it's something I've actually had trouble with on my webcam, is the camera trying to readjust and focus as it's filming. So hopefully this one's going to be a little better. I shot a couple clips of this piece before this one, and had it like just autoed out, let it just do what it thought was best, and boy man, it came out super kind of oversaturated. And like my hands were like glowing yellow, and then also it was really trying to adjust for like the light. It was kind of really jumping the exposure up and down. So now I got the exposure locked off, I got the ISO locked off, and pretty much everything except for the focus locked off. So we'll see how this clip comes out. One thing I noticed about this camera that's really cool though is it seems like the mic is just awesome on it. So I'm gonna see, like, because like with my old point and shoot, that mic was almost completely worthless. It just was super low, and the only way it would pick up your voice is if you kind of just held it right in front of your mouth like a microphone. And so I always had to record all my audio from my webcam, and that meant I had to be in the studio. But with this one, I don't know, I might be able to, kind of take it out and record stuff on the fly and all that. So I'm looking forward to seeing how it works and taking it out tomorrow and giving it kind of a test run in the field and stuff. So we'll see we'll see how this video comes out. There might be all kinds of crazy footage and cuts in it and everything. So I also wanted to mention, let me see what time we're at. So I got 3 minutes on that clip. Also wanted to mention, I'm sorry, I had to take down my last video, not the Wonder Woman speed paint, that one's still up, but I did one a few days before that. It was a Blade Runner piece, and the client, excuse me, it was kind of my own fault. This client I'm working for, that was his artwork I was working on, and he saw the video and I don't know, didn't want, basically just didn't want it, this stuff out there, and so he kind of threw a little bit of a fit and wanted me to take it down, and I didn't really want to argue, I guess, and so I just went ahead and took it down, which it kind of sucks. I mean, because the thing of what I hate losing about that was, I had some, like, I thought some pretty good footage of, you know, because, like, the whole video wasn't about his project anyway, and I don't think anybody could have even guessed what his project is just from what I had filmed. But I had some really good shots of Tristan, and, you know, like in the video, it was me and him kind of exploring around. There was a bunch of clips of that, and I had some stuff about my mom in there that I recorded that I liked and wanted to keep, and, you know. Now I had to take it down, but eventually, you know, whenever his project gets done, if it ever does, I'll probably put that one back up, so. Okay, hey. So I actually stopped it for a bit and I watched that that last footage, and I'm actually really, really, really happy with the way this thing is looking. I think I've got the right camera finally, so we'll see how it looks when it comes out the other end of the editing. I was listening to the audio also, and man, it sounds really, really good. I think it actually sounds better than what comes out of my webcam. So I think I'm just going to try to make this into a little video blog. I wasn't quite sure when I first started talking. I kind of was thinking maybe I'd do some editing or something and try to put it all into, you know what I mean, kind of like, I don't know, into an edited video basically, and I don't know, I was just kind of listening to it and it actually sounds fine. I was just kind of talking to check the audio, I guess, and yeah, what I was talking about sounds good, so why not just make a video out of it. You know, it's funny, it's like, I mean, you guys that are, like, following me probably know, it's like, oops, got a mosquito in here, it's buzzing around me. I thought they were all dead already, I haven't seen any for a while. It's getting a little bit cooler, I guess fall's coming on, so. But anyway, yeah, I don't know what to call my, like, my video blogs anymore, because I'm doing that show with Kevin and Scott now, and we decided to call it the Art Casters, and I was fine with that, because I was thinking, I probably won't be doing any more art casts anyway, but I was kind of thinking about, like, the shows, like the working hangout type shows. And I didn't really think about, like, you know, like my sort of solo video blog things. So I don't know what to call them anymore. I mean, I'm not sure, so. I guess I could just keep on calling them the Artcast, but I feel like I kind of gave that name away, so I need to figure out something new. I know, and it's like the part I'm drawing on this piece, it's like so early on. I just broke my pencil lid. But it's so early on that it's not even really like a cool part of the piece. But I don't know, I wanted to get my camera out and try it out. I got it earlier today, so I was just jonesing to give it a shot. Guess I could talk a little about what I'm drawing. Obviously Harrison Ford. I'd probably make kind of like one of those speed paint type videos. of this one once I get it done and, you know, get all the footage together. I like those, and I kind of like having them just for like the print later on. It's almost like a good commercial for the print. And then plus it seems like people, you know, you don't have to be like an artist to watch those. You can just be, you know, into art or watching a video or whatever. And they're fun. I mean, like this kind of show, like where I'm just sitting around talking, it's almost like, I think it's more, you know, it's like you're probably an artist if you're listening in some way. Because it's just, you know, who's going to sit around and listen to like a video that's like 30 minutes long unless you're like drawing or something, you know, so. in that last kind of speed paint one, the one with the Wonder Woman, though, I didn't speed up any of the footage, and I actually like it a lot better. I was trying to think, like, when I started speeding up footage, because I was really adamant about not doing that for the longest time. This was kind of before the Artcast days when I used to, all my videos were kind of edited. If you kind of go back, there's like, you know, some sketch card videos and stuff. And one with Luke and Yoda, you know, from Empire Strikes Back, or that Conan one. Those were all kind of like in real time. I mean, they're edited, they're like, you know, they have like transitions, but in general they're all kind of like my hands moving like the speed it normally moves, which seems like slow compared to like a lot of other people's videos. But I used to not like speed paints. I used to always think speed paints were like really boring, and I didn't want to do videos like that. And I was trying to like remember like why I switched over. I remember I had my friend Sean was you know, he was always like on me to make like a speed paint and, you know, film something from beginning to end. And I think that was the first one I did it on. I think it was like that Legend of the Seeker video. Legend of the Seeker was like a show that was on a few years back. I think it's canceled now. It's a pretty good show though. It's kind of like a fantasy type show. Anyway, somebody had me do a sketch card from that show, and in that video, I kind of did like the full speed paint. But I don't know. I don't know that it. I know there's like some people that really kind of like want the whole speed paint, like beginning to end and all that kind of stuff. I see a lot of people actually bitching about, like, you know, like the way, you know, like when it's a sped up footage, about like how people's hands move and stuff. So I wonder what like everybody's opinion of that whole thing is. Or is anybody even watching what I do? I mean, is the whole like attraction of my videos just me talking, you know? I guess you guys could put it in the comments. I'm not sure I want to hear them though. You know, because I kind of like just doing how I do it. There's a guy I watch, I think it's his channel's called Portrait Art or something like that. He's a really good artist on YouTube, has a lot of subscribers and stuff. Almost all of his videos are, you know, full-on speed paints. I'll try to link that if I remember that guy's channel, because he really is freaking good artist. And he does just all portraits, and most of them are, you know, they're not really, you know, like everybody like that he does seems to be like famous, like in the news type people, you know, like I don't know, you name it. name somebody in the news and he's probably drawn him, which I'm sure he kind of does that to, you know, gain hits and stuff and be like topical and all that kind of thing. But there's nothing wrong with that. Anyway, I was watching one of his videos. I've watched them for a long time, and in general, they're like all, you know, they're like 100% speed paint with no talking at all, and they're sped up, like the camera's somewhere above him, I'd imagine, and it's just like, you know, the board's taped down, and he just, you know, just goes to town 100 miles an hour and does like this really incredible portrait of whoever, you know, and it's just like beginning to end, and it kind of has like music, like some of the music I've been finding lately and stuff. Okay, so looks like the camera actually turned off automatically right there. And I checked, it says I got 4 minutes, so I'm guessing it might turn off at like every 10 minutes or something. That's kind of the way a lot of DSLRs do it. I didn't actually know that. Kevin told me that here recently, and I kind of researched it. Anyway, but that's fine. At least it dinged. My old camera used to just turn off, and I wouldn't realize it, and then I'd think I would be recording like another 10 minutes, and then I realized I lost a bunch of stuff. But anyway, back to what I was saying. What was I talking about now? Well, anyway, this guy, the portrait art guy on YouTube, when, you know, the video's so sped up because, you know, he's shoving a whole, you know, 10 or 20 hour drawing into, like, you know, 5 minutes. And his hand's, like, moving so quick, you can't see really any technique in what he's doing, like, at all. And I'm not criticizing the guy, I actually really like his videos and stuff, but there's maybe one or two videos where he talks, like recently, and I like those two. They're just very standard, like answering questions, but they're good videos. They're pretty good. He seems like a really nice guy, so But yeah, anyway, that I think that's like the one part of it I don't dig much. It's just, I want to see, like, there's something, I think, I don't want to be all like, well, my way's the only way, but the thing I liked about the Wonder Woman video, though, was I felt like it was, you know, when my hand isn't, like, super sped up, it seemed, I mean, it's more, it just seems to be like some kind of a little bit more humanity to it or something, you know? It's more real in a way or something, I don't know. Maybe I'm just being crazy. But anyway. Yeah, I almost didn't draw this one. This is kind of from a production shot, I think, from Empire Strikes Back. So, you know, Han Solo, of course, just standing in the tunnel. I think maybe after him and Leia get into, like, the fight about him leaving, you know, when they're on Hoth, you know. And it's definitely not from the movie. It's like a shot that like a photographer took of him, and I don't know, man, it's just like it's just one of those pieces that just, and you guys will see more when it's done, but it just completely depends on like the drawing, you know, if you can't, or if I can't draw it well enough, it's just not going to fly. And I thought, you know, maybe I should really, you know, hunt up a different photo of him, you know, with his blaster and stuff, and make it sort of like the more easy sell. Because he doesn't even have the vest on in this one, you know, so. But I really like the look of his face in this. I mean, that's, you know, it's just all on, like, the portrait, you know. It's just, like, all on the drawing. And that was kind of like that Wonder Woman piece a little bit. Where it was just, like, I knew, like, if I couldn't get that thing drawn right, it just wasn't going to fly. Because she wasn't, you know, her expression and everything was just much more, like, unusual way, you know, in a way. She wasn't, like, just smiling and posing, and it looked like kind of a shot, like the photo looked like a shot that was more, you know, kind of candid. Okay, so I'm back. So that time the card folded up, but I'll have to grab a couple new cards and do it this way. I don't know, it might just be easier to do the audio on the webcam like I've been doing. But I want to try it this way. But I kind of watched a little bit of the video I just recorded there, and yeah, so far I think it's working. I think I probably have enough, you know, like once I kind of fill up another clip here to do like a 30 minute, you know, little video blog. So that's pretty cool. So I was kind of talking about the portrait right before it got cut off there. Well, I don't remember exactly what I was talking about, but like this piece, I mean, I think what I was trying to get to was just, like with this Harrison Ford piece, I felt like, I feel like, you know, unless it's like a good portrait, it's just not going to work. So, I don't usually draw too fast anyway, but, like, just as I drew this first part, and especially the eyes and stuff, I really just focused on just like taking as long as it takes and just getting it right. Because it just, you know, to me it's just like, unless it's like a really excellent portrait, I just, you know, I don't think this piece is gonna work. So and that's, I think, because it is just kind of like an unusual shot of him. Because sometimes I think, you know, you can do like the, you know, like the Harrison Ford and Chewbacca, you know, when they're standing in front of the Millennium Falcon, like firing, firing their blasters, like when they're escaping the Death Star. And like everybody's seen that scene so many times, it's just like, you know, I think you can like mess the portraits up a little bit and you're still going to know who they are, and people still just accept it, you know. But with something like this, it's just, you know, it's not, you know, it's just not usual, and you just got to be more like right on the money. So and I find, you know, sometimes I think just maybe just getting older or something, sometimes, like, well, should I even, I was gonna say I can feel myself getting kind of lazy at times. But I don't know, and I thought maybe I shouldn't say that on camera, but I don't think it's lazy. I mean, it's more like, I let my style, I think, can kind of carry it sometimes when I don't feel like really getting in there and figuring out, you know, what's what, like on really detailed, you know, hair or something sometimes. I'll just, with that, you know, impressionistic style thing that I have a little bit of. Kind of just take over and carry it, and you know, so I don't have to stay in there for hours and hours. I used to think I might want to be a wildlife artist like a long time ago, and man, I tell you, I think the worst part of that would have to be you know, painting all that hair all the time. I've done some animals and stuff, you know, in the past, and I always enjoy the faces. It's kind of like the people I draw. I always enjoy the faces, but then it's like, you know, when I'm into like the body and all that kind of stuff, it just could get super monotonous, you know. Enjoying drawing though lately. I don't know what it is, but I just have this really wanted to do to draw, and just haven't, man, you know, it's just been hard for me to paint. I wonder if it's just because I just got all super stressed last month, you know. Which I don't want to keep bringing it up, but like with what happened with my dad, it's just, I just wonder if I just got like way overkill stress, and you know, because you know, art still is kind of like an escape for me, even though it is my day job. It's still the kind of thing where like when things aren't going good, and I know this is one of the reasons I became like a good artist, is because you know. Just when, you know, you're younger and I don't know, you got problems, you know, whatever they are, stressing you out, you know. And I had some. I didn't have a horrible childhood, but you know, just there's no stuff, you know. And you know, it was like it was a little bit of like an escape, you know. You go in your room and just, you know, turn your brain off and go into a different world or something, you know. Drawing your comics or whatever, your scene from whatever it is. And I notice, like, I'll do that now sometimes, like, when I'm really feeling kind of bad, or, like, even, like, sometimes, like, when I'm sick, I notice, like, a lot of times when I'm sick, I actually work more than when I'm feeling good. And I think that's just because it just makes me feel better to just kind of zone out and sit there and scribble, you know. Anyway, I guess that's probably a pretty good video. I think I'm just gonna wrap it up there. Sure this piece will be done in a day or two, and then you guys can check out the way it ended up. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and take care, and see you guys next time.